Hello, everybody. Welcome to Machine Minutes with Grove. Today, we will discuss uses of probing in jog mode. To find these probing options, first be sure you are in jog mode. Then press Measure Workpiece at the bottom of the screen. To the right will be all the probing options available. For each probing option, you can select Measure Only or Work Offset. To set a work offset, you first open the drop-down menu that says Measure Only and select Work Offset. Next, select which work offset you would like to set by clicking and scrolling in the box to the right, or you can select the Work Offset soft key on the right side of the screen. Next, we will show you how to use most probing options on the control step by step. The first probing option we will demonstrate is on the single point probing cycle. To measure a feature, make sure the text box says Measure Only and not Work Offset. Jog the probe to the position that you would like the probing cycle to start in. The options for which axis you would like to probe with are listed on the right side of the screen. To change the direction in which you would like to probe, simply press the plus or minus shown next to the words measuring direction and select the drop-down menu. Once in position, press cycle start. After the probing cycle is complete, it will display a measurement value at the bottom right of the screen. Next, we'll demonstrate the align edge option. This feature allows us to align the rotary axes to linear axes by probing two points. After you select the axis and direction you are probing in, the next step is to probe the two points labeled P1 and P2. Move the machine to the position you would like to probe at using the controls in jog mode. Once in position, press cycle start. After the cycle has been ran, the measurement value will automatically be saved as P1 on the right side of the screen. Jog the probe to the second position and repeat the process. Once both points are probed, press the Calculate soft key at the bottom right. This will provide the angle value. Moving on to our next option is the Spacing Two Edges cycle, which finds the center point of the axis you selected and distance between those two points. Again, for this option, you will select the axis and direction in which you would like to probe. Once those are selected and you've moved the probe into position, press cycle start. A value will automatically be saved as P1. Move the probe to the next position and repeat the process for P2. After the measurements are taken, press the calculation soft key at the bottom right. This will generate the distance between the two edges and the center point of the axis you have selected. Next are two very similar cycles called rectangular corner and any corner probing cycles. The rectangular corner cycle only needs the user to probe three points, as it should be used for right angle corner probing. The any corner cycle needs four points probed in order to give the angle and position measurements. Since the any corner cycle is more complex, we will demonstrate using this cycle. Both cycles can be used on inside or outside corners using multiple different position options. Select whichever applies to your application. Jog the probe to position one as shown on the screen. Once in position, press cycle start. A value will automatically be saved as P1 and display on the right side of the screen. Repeat the process for the other three positions. Once all four positions are probed and saved, press the calculate soft key on the right side of the screen. This will generate the alignment angle, corner angle, and zero point for the X and Y. The next couple options are differentiated, either being a pocket or a spigot, also known as extruded surface. Since they have the same concepts, we will show you one of each, and you can take that same technique and apply it to the others. For this example, we will demonstrate the rectangular spigot, which allows us to measure an extruded surface. Jog the probe to the estimated center point of the rectangle. Input the width and length values of the rectangle into the text box. For width, enter the y-axis measurement, and for length, enter the x-axis measurement. DZ is the incremental value from the current Z value to the Z probing position. Once all inputs are verified and entered, press cycle start. After the cycle is finished, the results for the width, length, and center points of X and Y for the extruded surface will be displayed at the bottom right. Next is a very similar cycle. Instead of using a rectangular shape, we are using a circle or a circled spigot, also known as an extruded cylinder. We are able to probe up to 4 holes or circle spigots at a time. Since all these cycles are very similar, we decided to only perform one demonstration and probe 4 holes. Type in the size of the hole being probed. Then for the angle offset text field, select yes. Jog the probe to position 1 as shown on the screen. Once in position, press cycle start. After the cycle has been ran, the measurement value will automatically be saved as P1 on the right side of the screen. Repeat the process for the other 3 positions in the order shown on the screen. Once all 4 positions are probed and saved, press the calculate soft key on the right side of the screen. This will generate the x-axis alignment between hole 1 and 2, as well as the center point in relation to all the holes or circle spigots. Lastly, we will demonstrate the line plane probing option. This cycle requires 3 probing positions in the shape of a triangle to gather both the alpha and beta angles. Jog the probe to the first position, which you would like to use as a reference point, and press cycle start. After the cycle has been ran, the measurement value will automatically be saved as P1 on the right side of the screen. Repeat the process for the following 2 positions by moving either in the X or Y direction, or both. Once all 3 positions are probed and saved, press calculate soft key on the right side of the screen. This will generate both the alpha and the beta angles. All these basic probing options can be found in your Grove Machining Center in jog mode. Join us in our upcoming video to learn more about your Grove Machining Center. Until then, stay productive, keep cutting, and we'll catch you next time.